Hello, I'm Melissa Long at the CNN Center here in Atlanta with some of the headlines that are now in the news. And it's Tuesday. A series of explosions rocked Jaipur in quick succession today. It is a city southwest of India's capital, New Delhi. The Associated Press reports 30 people were killed. One blast went off near a crowded temple, another near a bakery. No claim of responsibility. Devastation and misery in central China. The death toll from Monday's 7.9 magnitude earthquake has now topped 12,000 in Sichuan province. Hundreds of students are still trapped under the rubble of their middle school. At least 50 bodies have been recovered, along with 10 survivors. Still, an estimated 26,000 people are hurt and thousands more missing. Florida firefighters are hoping the weather gives them some help today. They are trying to contain a wildfire that scorched about 6 square miles in Brevard County. Schools in Palm Bay are closed because of the fire. The town's assistant fire chief says there were some flare-ups overnight. And now the winds are dying down. A fire in Daytona Beach forced about 500 families from their homes. It is now under control, and the evacuation order has been lifted. Senator Hillary Clinton is looking forward to a victory party after the polls close in West Virginia tonight. Clinton is widely expected to score a convincing win in the Democratic presidential primary. There are 28 delegates at stake in West Virginia. Senator Barack Obama spent little money or time in West Virginia. If he loses, he's increasing his delegate lead. Still, 6 more uncommitted superdelegates have endorsed him in the past 24 hours. CNN has learned that Chelsea Clinton will be campaigning for her mom in Puerto Rico this week. Puerto Rico holds its presidential primary on June 1st. The decision to send Chelsea to the island appears to signal her mother's intention to remain in the race until at least early next month. If your significant other seems put off by all the attention you give your electronic devices, you're not alone. There's a new study that finds more than 63% of BlackBerry users take it with them to the bathroom. 37% of laptop owners frequently use their computers in bed. A counselor says today's couples often find it challenging to keep the communication devices from interfering with actually communicating. Those are the headlines making news for you at this hour. For more on these stories or continuing coverage of the latest news, of course, CNN.com is a great site. Of course, you can tune into CNN television. Or if you happen to be on the go, don't forget about relying on your cell phone, relying on your BlackBerry, and CNN.com updates.